Hi everyone, today I'm going to begin by showing you around the famous Kakao Friends store in Hongdae. I'm full of cheer, so let's see what they have to offer inside. Oh, Ryan's here to greet me. 안녕하세요. He loves me really. The store is huge with a wide range of soft toys and gifts. They're super expensive for what they are, but if you're after a souvenir, then it's a great place to look. What I'm interested in though is a little further in the store upstairs. And I'll admit I was a little surprised as I wasn't expecting this, a cafe. Not just any cafe though, all of the food and even drink items seem a little more grown up. They even do cocktails, and here I was thinking this is a kid's store. Not at all. The selection of cakes and pastries is amazing. I'm going to choose a sweet and savoury item and a couple of cocktails. The total comes to 19,701. I've chosen a hot dog and a cake, and I'm going with a Jeju Gamgyo Makgeolli and a Yuzu Mojito. Wow, these look special. I really don't feel like I'm in a Kakao Friends store at all. It's so strange. Makgeolli is basically a rice-based liquor, and this one's flavoured with gamgyul, or in English, tangerine. It's my favourite fruit in the world, but this one doesn't taste like it at all. It doesn't even taste like makgeolli really, it's a bit weird but very drinkable. Still expensive at 4,901, which is a half price special, so... And the yuzu mojito? Wow. Tangy and sweet with lots of mint. This is amazing, and cost me 5,401. Again, half price. Have a look at this hot dog. It's basically a sausage in a bun with cheese on top. This looks fancy and it's super savoury and delicious. 5,501. Well, I'd say it's worth it. And here's the chocolate berry cake. It feels a little dense and, to be honest, it's nothing special. But the presentation makes up for it a little. I wouldn't buy it again though. They don't only sell soft toys, they sell... Hang on, what's this? Oh, sorry, I thought... Well, no, never mind what I thought. It's just a thermometer. Just a thermometer. Venturing back into Hongdae, I'm going to show you a cheap noodle place that I love. This guy, Mr. Pak, is famous in Korea, and he runs a chain of these noodle restaurants. They're super cheap and convenient. So I'm going to try these noodles, the nenguksu, which are cold noodles in broth, and myeolchiguksu, which are anchovy noodles. Now I know that you're probably thinking anchovies are quite fishy and smelly, but trust me, there's no strong smell, just a rich tasting broth and delicious noodles. All noodles are ordered via this touchscreen, but there's only one, so it's a little bit busy. My order of noodles came to 9,000 won, around £6. That's really cheap. Oh my god, it only took them about a minute and they're ready. This one's the anchovy noodles, and it's huge. There's a lot of broth, some fried tofu and noodles, along with some gim, which is seaweed. It's not boiling hot, so you can eat it straight away, which is another good thing about the meal. I love it. The broth is rich, but also light, if that makes sense. The noodles, along with the fried tofu, make an interesting texture in your mouth. It's fantastic. The nenguksu is cold. You can even see the ice in the broth. I can't wait to try this as I've never had it before. Like the other noodles I tried, it's delicious and refreshing, especially on a hot day. I recommend either. So of course this is a Korean restaurant, there's lots of free kimchi to eat. Delicious. Ooh, pajamas. I could do with some of those. 10,000 won, bargain. Next stop is Lotteria. I don't fancy a burger. I'm actually going to have some of their other items like this kwabegi. If you remember, I had one of these at Gwangjang Market, so I'd like to see how it compares. This one comes in a set deal with a kind of mixed grain drink. Sounds healthy. What doesn't sound healthy is cream cheese balls. They sound tasty though. I also want to try this jippy, which as I understand is Taiwanese style fried chicken. It says spicy, but I doubt it will be. We'll see. Okay, time to clean my hands. Oh, hang on, that's syrup. Aha, that's better. The donut comes with a sachet of sugar to sprinkle on top. I wish they did this themselves as the donut feels pretty cold. The sugar would probably stick better if it was warm. Never mind. Oh, there's hardly any sugar on this one. There's pretty much all in the bag. It tastes okay, but it's nowhere near the quality of the donut I ate in the market. Let's try this cheesy ball. Interesting. The dough reminds me of Korean donuts, and it tastes a bit tangy. I think it's okay, but it's nothing amazing. And how about the mixed grain drink? Well, it's quite light in flavour and it almost tastes healthy. I think it's great and it's quite refreshing. I'm not a big fan of soft drinks and I think this one works quite well. Let's try this, the jippy or whatever it's called. Wow, the chicken is a little spicy and tender. The batter's really crispy. This is amazing. Oof, super hot though. Not in taste, but temperature. It was expensive at 4,700 won, but I'd gladly buy it again. It's quite unique. I wanted to show you a bit of Myeongdong, which was a really busy touristic area that I like to visit, but since COVID, it's dead. These streets used to be so busy, it's a bit spooky. Anyway, last stop is here, where I'm going to buy some hot dog. The ones this guy's making is pretty large. I just want one of the brown sugar hot dogs for 1,000 won. Anyway, let's try. Oh, hot. Oh my god. It's so hot. It's just the steam inside that's burning me. You really need to let it cool down, or if you're insane, then just eat it straight away, like me. If you can fight through the pain, then it's delicious. And if you look inside, you can see sesame seeds and molten sugar. Do be careful. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed yourselves. Until next time, bye.